You're listening to the sounds of Salford from the UK going out to the world.
Where do we go now? Hi, good afternoon, and welcome to Archie's 80's Classic. You're listening to the Housewife's Choice. How are you, Paul?
I'm all right, mate. The new Jimmy Young.
Well, you're better than Jimmy Young. Jimmy Young don't get as many requests as you do.
What's the recipe today, Jim?
I know, yeah.
It's a long one, isn't it?
It is a long one, yeah. You've got a lot of requests,
20.
Though, very yeah. popular.
20. Yeah.
Me and Noddy get about 3.
I know.
Me and Dennis don't get any.
Nah.
Well, we do. We get one off Ray Dixon Smith.
Yeah, or London Boys with Jay Carter.
Well, yeah, that's the number one. But that was just a joke, Jason.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
Well, that was a good start, mate, wasn't it?
That was a great start. Bit Guns N' Roses. Sweet Child of Mine.
Baz and Steph.
Is that for our patron?
Yes, our patron, young Steph. Missing him these days. I've not seen him
for
ages.
Yeah, I've not seen him for a bit myself. Yeah, have to come down, Baz, and we get on a show sometime with me and Archie.
Yeah.
Doing Archie's 80s club.
We've got a bit to talk about today, mate. We'll mention a bit, a few things later about how precious life is. Something that happened to me on Thursday night with Reese.
Oh, mate. Yeah, a full Chinese, didn't
he? Yeah, it was frightening. Well, I'll tell you what happened now. We were just sat there having something to eat, and he went away and came back, and all of a sudden his eyes were watering, and his lips started swelling, and his body started burning, and the next thing you know, he said, my throat was closed, so he said, my feels like somebody's got a grip on me on my throat, and I thought he's having an anaphylactic shock. So I rang my mate, as you know, I drive the doctors.
Yeah.
I rang one of the doctors and spoke to the Dr. Islow and told him dial 999 immediately.
Yeah.
So I thought, Jesus Christ, he said he's having an anaphylactic shock.
And where was this, in the restaurant?
No, this was in our house.
Right.
This was in our house. So I thought, well, rather than ring 999, I might as well just throw him in the car.
Yeah, quicker than
Took him to the hospital. They just took one look at him and shouted, anaphylactic shock, and there was doctors running everywhere.
Was it?
And his throat was closing, his heartbeat went up to 200.
Yeah.
And his just throat was closing, he couldn't breathe.
Well, I'm glad.
Horrendous.
I'm glad.
But fair play, yeah. I mean, the doctor was fantastic. He said, look, don't panic, we know what it is. Within 20 minutes, you'll be back to normal. And he gave him injections of adrenaline and piriton and other stuff. And within 20 minutes, the heartbeat had dropped back down to 100. And
so it's scary, wasn't it?
But we don't know what's caused it. We had exactly the same meal the week before.
So, well, I'll tell you what, mate. A word of advice from the Sounds of Salford. Stay away from that meal.
Stay on chips and egg.
Yes.
Yeah.
Eat English.
Yeah. So, luckily, you know, he's fine, but he's got an EpiPen now, so he's got to carry that around with him for the rest of his life.
What's an EpiPen?
It's like a diabetic pen,
right,
but it's full of an adrenaline. So if it happens again, and he's,
just,
you know,
pumps
he
can himself
bang,
up, like,
pump it until you get to the hospital.
Great.
So,
stuff.
But,
well,
you know, from,
but it's good that he's got something with him, isn't it?
Yeah,
you know,
so I'd like to
say,
you know, it gets reputable as one of the best hospitals. And
it is the best hospital.
It is.
World.
It's spotlessly
all
clean.
Angels.
It's the doctors
angels,
and nurses,
mate,
couldn't do enough, mate. They were absolutely fantastic. So we spent all night there. We had to stay there for 6 hours under observation. But yeah, he's right as rain.
Well, that's the main thing. Has he brought my top?
No, he's forgot your top.
He's forgot my top. Okay.
I'll get it. I'll put it in a can and I've got it.
Have you done the pictures?
No, not done them. I'll do. Also, where would
have you done the membership forms?
I've not got anything. You don't send any membership forms.
I have sent them, though.
You haven't?
Via email.
Have you?
Do you ever check your emails?
No.
I'll have to send it.
And I also want to put a big shout out at the moment for a really, really good friend of mine, Fredwin, whose daughter, Hayley, came out of Bonnie's the other night.
Right.
Low Broughton Road, crossed Low Broughton Road in the rain. Didn't look. Taxis hit her. She's in intensive care at the moment. In Hope Hospital, in an induced coma. So come on, Ailey.
Come on, pull through. Everyone here that sounds so pretty,
hoping
for you.
She's a great girl, a fantastic girl, and her dad's a really, really big mate of mine in Bonnie's.
Yeah.
So come on, Ailey.
Come on,
Ailey. You can do this.
Pull through, girl. Do it for us.
So we'll play a bit of Phyllis Nelson for you, Ailey, and would request this to all the Wynn family. Hope Ailey makes a speedy recovery in the next few days, and God bless her. We've all said prayers for her. And this is a bit of Phyllis Nelson and a bit of Move Closer from 1985.
But in the meantime, when we're together, touching each other,
was a sign of Phyllis Nelson going out, especially for Hayley, and also for another good friend of mine, for Julie Simpson as well. Right, we're going to move on to, we're going to double up here, mate.
Double up? Ooh, some double up.
Two Langworthy and Salford Reds fans.
Who's that, mate?
Firstly, for Leo Murph.
Oh, Leo, yeah. Stevie Nash Murphy, yeah. Yes.
And big Ian Mez. Ian Mezzo.
Mezzo, how are you, Mezzo? Yeah. He picked three in a row yesterday on Saturday morning show.
He had a go at me for choosing Gilbert O'Sullivan. He said,
"Oh, O'Sullivan's the best, aren't he? We're going to get Gilbert O'Sullivan to number one. Never mind anyone else.
I'll be playing Joe Dolce next. Shut up at your face," he said, Mez.